Peace, family. Welcome to another episode of YP Higher Perspective. We review internet media content via news clips, entertainment, or everyday recordings, and we give you a higher cognitive disposition in regards to the subject matter at hand. Today, family, we're going to be doing a higher perspective on Snoop Dogg apologizing to Gayle King in regards to a response video that he posted on his Instagram for what we all were upset about, which is her bringing up Kobe Bryant's rape allegations after his unfortunate and untimely death. And so what we're going to do is we're going to play the video, okay, that Snoop Dogg posted on his Instagram. I believe he did two apologies. I'm only going to play one because I don't even want to hear the other one. So I'm going to play one, and then we're going to give our higher perspective, family. And with that being said, here we go. As I always do, we finna pull up that video. Ready? I am. Here we go. Bam.
I'm at you live and direct with a message. Two wrongs don't make no right. When you're wrong, you gotta fix it.
So with that being said, Gayle King,
I publicly tore you down by coming at you in a derogatory manner based off of emotions, me being angry at questions that you asked.
Overreacted.
I should have handled it way different than that. I was raised way better than that. So I would like to apologize to you publicly for the language that I used and calling you out of your name and just being disrespectful. I didn't mean for it to be like that. I was just expressing myself for a friend that wasn't here to defend himself.
A lot of people look up to
me. And they love me and they appreciate me, so I want to let them know that. Anytime you mess up, it's okay to fix it. It's okay to man up and say that you're wrong. I apologize. Hopefully we can sit down and talk privately. Have a good day.
Okay, now I'm jumping right up on this one, okay? Now, this is my higher perspective, so I'm going to try to stay in my higher self as much as possible. But I must keep it all the way 1,000, 2,000 in this instance. I am very disappointed and highly disgusted at Snoop Dogg. I was actually getting ready to do a video defending Snoop Dogg, and then he posted these apologies, right? Now, most of y'all might say, well, Pharaoh, that was the mature thing to do for him to apologize. Let me tell you why. I'm going to give you a higher perspective and specifically why Snoop Dogg himself should never apologize. And then I'm going to give you a higher perspective, period, of why black people, period, should not be apologizing for anything that was said to Gayle King. People say, well, what about she received threats? So what? And I'm going to tell you why so what. But I'm going to come back to why I say so what in a minute. So hold that thought. Snoop Dogg should not apologize to Gayle King. Why? Snoop Dogg was preserving the honor of Kobe Bryant. Now here's my issue with Snoop Dogg. Snoop Dogg, and I'm not going to say he's gang affiliated. So I'm just going to say Snoop Dogg public persona is affiliated with being from L.A., being from the streets of L.A. Now, here's a question for Snoop Dogg. If one of your homies in L.A. die, okay, and y'all at the damn candle visual, and a female comes up there and says, hey, did y'all know this guy was gay and he really wasn't gay, what do you think would happen? Let me give you an example. Nipsey Hussle. Rest in peace, Nipsey, but I'm going to use you for a second. If somebody at Nipsey Hussle's candle visual would have brought up allegations, huh, that Nipsey Hussle was gay or that he raped somebody, what do you think would have happened to her? Now, why am I bringing this up? Snoop Dogg knows about code and principle more than anybody in the industry, okay? He from L.A. We not going to play this game. This the same nigga that made 187 on an undercover cop. So, Snoop Dogg, is you going to apologize to the LAPD for talking about basically making a song about undercover police officers being knocked off trying to do their job? Come on now. Is you serious? This the same nigga that made 187 on an undercover cop and all the other gangster songs he made. So why would he apologize when he's actually in the right? This is what I'm trying to figure out. Somebody that's dearly loved, okay, for whatever reason, it don't gotta be Kobe Bryant, it could be anybody. Somebody who's dearly loved and adored by the public, okay, has their character and their image and their brand being tarnished for viewership, okay? during an interview. Huh? Gail King, excuse me, had all this time to bring this up, waited till the man died to bring it up. You did the right thing, Snoop. And then you apologize. Why? Why? That just leads me to believe Snoop Dogg not really built like he claimed. Because of a little bit of public pressure. Because a couple white people got upset. So this just goes to show you that what white people say and what white people think holds more value to Snoop Dogg than actual principles in his friendship with Kobe Bryant. I don't care who feels some type of way about me saying that. That's what it is. Because he didn't apologize because of black people. Because we were behind you. So it leads me to believe that if some white people put pressure on Snoop Dogg and all of his principles went out the window and he apologized, not because he upset black people, because we agree, because he upset white people. Now, let me tell you why I said it doesn't matter if Gayle King's being threatened. Because you got people talking about she's being threatened. He ain't threatened that woman. He ain't threatened that woman. He was speaking figuratively and colorfully. But even if he did threaten that woman, let me tell you why it don't matter. People keep saying, well, was it right or was it wrong that Gayle King brought up Kobe Bryant's death? I mean, Kobe Bryant's alleged rape charge after death, right? I'm going to tell you why it doesn't matter. I'm going to go out on a limb and say it doesn't even matter if Kobe Bryant raped her and killed her. I wouldn't care if Kobe Bryant did rape. I wouldn't care if Kobe Bryant was a serial rapist and it come out next week. Now you're going to say, Pharrell, why would you say that? You know, don't you still go to school and pledge allegiance to the flag? America hasn't apologized to us yet. Huh? Don't you still see the national anthem? That's a racist song about slavery. America hasn't apologized to us yet. Don't you still learn about all of the presidents in this country? Every last one of them was racist. Hence, George Washington. You learn about him. Your kids learn about him. Not only did he own slaves, he snatched the teeth out of one of his slaves' mouths to make dentures. So when we talk about where the dentures come from, you can thank George Washington for that. George Washington helped with the succession and the invention of dentures by practicing on his personal slaves by taking their teeth out their mouth and putting them in heads. Do you see white people apologizing for that? No. Don't you still celebrate George Washington? Yes. Abraham Lincoln had slaves. Don't you still celebrate Abraham Lincoln Day? Yes. Christopher Columbus killed millions of black people. Raped so many black people that he raped so many black people, we became today what you call a Spanish person. Don't you still celebrate Columbus Day? Yes. Huh? Huh? Valentine's Day, based off pedophilia. Cupid is a pedophile Roman deity. Didn't you just spend $28 billion on Valentine's Day? Yes. And so my thing is this. What? Oh, I'm not done. Brad Pitt talking about he wanted to direct a movie for King Leopold. Now, King Leopold of Belgium is a white man who in the 1900s just went over to Africa and genocided 14 million Africans in the Congo. Now, Brad Pitt is about to make a movie directing and uplifting his life. So here's my thing. If Brad Pitt, aka a white man, could uplift and call a genocidal maniac a king and not apologize about it, why do we gotta apologize about preserving the legacy of a man who allegedly raped somebody, okay? It's not even confirmed. So my thing is, white people have actually done wicked things. They don't apologize for it. Nobody apologizes for what they do to Arabs. Arab people, when they came to Africa, they raped and they killed all of the men. And they kept the women. They raped these women so bad that they were able, over a period of time, to create an entire slave army that had numbers over 250,000 soldiers. That's 250,000 soldiers made from rape and slavery. And then they use these armies to go pillage the rest of Africa. If you calculate, because the Arabs actually taught white people how to enslave us. And Arab slavery was 20,000 worse than this little weak-ass American slavery y'all caught up on. If you calculate how many black people Arabs enslaved, we're not even counting today. We're talking about when they first popped off. Arabs are responsible for the murder of over 115 million Africans. And they raped black women so bad that they was able to create an army with the offsprings of the children to fight for them at a number exceeding 250,000. Go look it up. Now, why is this important? Have they apologized for that? No, they have not. Everybody shits on black people. Nobody has apologized. They even make you sing the songs. Huh? They even make you celebrate the people that enslaved you. Do you apologize for that? No. I mean, excuse me, did they apologize for that? No. So my thing is, I don't understand how Snoop Dogg or any black person feels that we owe anybody an apology. I don't care what they do. I don't care. People say, what if O.J. Simpson really killed that white girl? That's my football killing black person. You got your white people that like to do what they do and you celebrate them? Let us have ours. If people say, well, Kobe Bryant was a rapist and he did it, I wouldn't care if he did do it. I wouldn't care if the woman wasn't. I wouldn't care if Kobe Bryant raped her or was on camera and he tried to kill her and she escaped and he tried to sex traffic her. That's my three-point shooting, sex trafficking Laker. That's my, I like him. I don't care. You got your rapists and your murderers that you have, America, and I have mine. I don't have to apologize for what Kobe Bryant did if you don't got to apologize for what every goddamn president in the goddamn country has done. Bill Clinton locked all these niggas up. Huh? Hillary Clinton locked all these niggas up. You don't see them up. They still in the campaign running trying to get your vote like it never happened. So my thing is, Snoop Dogg is in the wrong for apologizing, period, because he's supposed to be G'd up. He's supposed to be living off principle. Come on, Snoop. If somebody in L.A. close to you die and I come to the memorial trying to tarnish their name, what you think gonna happen? So you was in the right, Snoop, for checking her and people saying you threatened her. You didn't threaten her. But even if you did threaten her, who cares? Who cares? They killing motherfuckers every day. For they threatening people for good. You got people on the internet putting out positive information and they threatening motherfuckers. You better not tell nobody about that information or we gonna kill. But the dude that wrote the Behold the White the dude that wrote Behold the Pale White Horse, they threatened him and killed him for good. So my thing is, why you gotta apologize when the people that's in power is doing the same shit you're being accused of doing on a grander scale? On a grander scale. You know how many people investigated Hillary Clinton and wound up dead? I'm not saying she did it. I'm just saying it's funny how every time the Clinton administration gets investigated, the investigator winds up dead. Gunshot back of the head type scenario. They rule it a suicide. Nobody apologized for that. So my thing is, why do black people always gotta be weak and on our knees and apologize? Why we can't never let our chest be out? So I'm here on behalf of the black community to retract Snoop Dogg's apology, and to tell Gayle King and whoever else is mad, black, white, whoever, bitch, we do not apologize. Excuse my language. We do not apologize. We meant what we said. Gayle King and Oprah, you are traitors. We don't like you. We don't claim you. I don't care if you die in a car accident today, I'm gonna pop a bottle and celebrate. Period. That's the higher perspective. Now, I know I normally don't go higher like that on this channel, but I must ride for principle. I'm tired of us always bowing down and being weak in the public eye, especially when we in the right and we always going out our way to do something for somebody that nobody else does, for nobody apologize to us. Nobody hold our hands and sugarcoat us. You got these white celebrities dressing these little boys up, these little black boys up like little girls, and they not apologizing us for that. But you can't defend the legacy of your friend. If Kobe Bryant is your friend and you want to defend his legacy because Gayle King is being a white supremacist pit bull and Oprah Winfrey is being a white supremacist pit bull, you defend your friend. And so I just want to, I'm ending on this. The higher perspective to this video is this. Snoop Dogg did not apologize on behalf of black people because we was riding with you. You apologize because some white person or some organization that's controlled by white people somewhere put some kind of pressure on you, okay? And you folded. And Snoop Dogg is now publicly the example of niggas that talk like they about that life, act like they for the people. Niggas make 187 on the undercover cop songs, but when that white man put that pressure on you, you fold every time. And so let this be an example of why we have not gone nowhere. You might say, Farrell, what's the example? Because when we're in the wrong, we don't stand up. But even worse, when we in the right, we go from standing up to laying down. And so we refuse to stand for anything. And we ain't falling because we've been failed. We just never even chose to get up. And so let this be a message to everybody out there. If you're not apologizing to me for everything you've done to me as a black man on this planet for the last 2,000 years, I'm not apologizing to you for nothing. Even if my people is in the wrong, that's my people. People say, well, Michael Jackson might have touched a little boy. I wouldn't care if he raped them little boys all through the house. That's my moonwalking, 360 spinning, glitter glove rocking rapist. That's my, I want to rock with you, number one hit on the Billboard charts rapist. Let me have him. Didn't Elvis date a 16-year-old? Huh? Or a 14-year-old? Ain't he still the king? Don't y'all still call him the king of rock? So if you can still celebrate Elvis, let us have Michael Jackson and leave us alone. So we don't have the burden to prove to you that the background of our idols and icons is squeaky clean. Because you still ain't proven to us that you give a damn about the fact that yours is not squeaky clean. You make me celebrate George Washington, and he for sure was a racist who slaughtered black people. Okay? But I have to prove to you that Kobe Bryant wasn't a rapist in order for me to celebrate him after his death? Please, keep put it like this. You got your savages of your race that you don't apologize for, and anybody of my race that you question, I won't be apologizing either. That don't mean I totally agree with their behavior, but that just means when it comes to you, and you know who I'm talking about, Gail King and your whole little circle, your whole little team, if y'all watching, I'm not apologizing. And don't ask again. Don't act. Matter of fact, next time you want to do an interview, Gail King, interview me and ask me if Kobe Bryant is a rapist. Because if you think what Snoop Dogg said was harsh, I'm going to charge that ass up. Oh, I'm going to charge that ass up. And so with that being said, this has been another episode of YP Higher Perspective Family. I had to get a little turnt on this one because this one was for the people. All of these are for the people, but this one was for them people. And so, Kobe Bryant, may you rest in peace. And may another black woman never vindictively put on her white collar leash and try to assassinate your character after death because she didn't have the heart to do it to your face. And because she felt safe as if the white man would do exactly what he did, which was put pressure on Snoop Dogg, and niggas gonna fold over principle. And so, Kobe Bryant, you need to know it's niggas that don't care about money, don't care about losing no money, don't care about losing no friends or losing nobody we network with. We care about honor and principle. And if I ever considered you a friend, whether you was white, black, or Spanish, and you die, I will not let nobody tarnish your name. This ain't just because you black. This is period. If I ever considered you a friend after death, I will lose my whole lifestyle to go out to make sure you go out with honor, if that's what it is. And so Snoop Dogg just let me know that he is not an honorable nigga. I don't want to hear him talking no more of that L.A. gangster, none of that. I don't want to hear him talking about 187 on the under. Just go ahead and smoke your weed, do your interviews with Jada Pinkett, and have a seat, because you just crushed yourself in the eyes of the people. And I don't want to hear you speaking on I don't want to hear you speaking on behalf of the people no more, because we know, nigga, you have no backbone to stand for the people, and you have no shield to go out on, let alone are you ready to go out on a shield. And with that being said, family, I love y'all. Peace.